Islamic countries are finally awakened.
A change that's taken place.
Define their own future without interference from the West.
Those Muslims calling for the removal of President Morsi are jahil, ignorant. That's the kind of thing my friend said on Wednesday night. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. On Wednesday night, President Morsi was removed by the Egyptian military. And as events unfolded, I was online discussing with activists from different Muslim groups. That's when somebody said that Muslims calling for the removal of President Morsi are jahil, ignorant. How could they support the secular opposition? 3 points come to mind. Number one, did the system change? Two, making the case for the Islamic Khilafah system. And three, convincing the Ummah. Firstly, did the system change? After the fall of Mubarak, Egyptian society was divided regarding what is the best system to govern the country going forward. Rather than settling that question, focus shifted to electing new politicians. So in reality, an American-controlled secular system remained largely intact. Muslims came to power, but Islam did not come to power. This has shown the fallacy of the idea that one can gradually Islamize the system by taking power at the helm of a non-Islamic system and implementing Islam gradually. Through the military, the US has ensured that the system effectively remains the same in Egypt in order to serve its interest, and this is a lesson for us all. Secondly, making the case for Islam. My friend said Muslims calling for Morsi's removal are ignorant. The issue is more complicated. Some of those calling for Morsi's removal are socialists. Some are secularists who say Islam must have no role in socio-economic matters. But many are practicing Muslims who voted for Morsi, who love Islam, who wear hijab, who fast in Ramadan. We, the Islamic activists from whatever group, have to admit that there is a contradiction in Egypt and parts of the Muslim world, which is that many people love Islam but are unaware of how Islamic-derived solutions can solve their day-to-day problems. Hence, they love Islam but look to secular solutions. They love Islam, look to secular solutions. Why should this be a surprise? What has been preached in our mosques for decades? Was the Khilafah ruling system explained as more than just a footnote in history? Were the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ about ruling, economy, foreign relations discussed and applied to today's realities? No. Throughout society, and even in some esteemed Islamic institutions, we have had the promotion of a secular Islam, primarily concerned with individual and spiritual matters. So on Wednesday, the Sheikh of Al-Azhar stood and endorsed the political roadmap set out by the Egyptian army chief, but did not offer the Islamic Khilafah ruling system as an alternative. Alhamdulillah, others from Al-Azhar opposed his stance. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not send Islam to address and solve life's problems? Did he not remind us? وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبِيَانَ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. We have sent down to you the book as clarification, as guidance and mercy, clarification for all things for you Muslims. A sad fact is that actually, while secular activists openly argue for secular solutions, we find some Islamic activists saying, it's not the time to talk about the Sharia, it's not the time to talk about Khilafah system and what solutions these have to offer society, not just Muslims. So how are people going to see that Islam has solutions to modern problems? And if we don't expose the shortcomings of the secular capitalist solutions, how would people see their fallacy? We should present Islam confidently, putting secularists and their unfit solutions on the back foot. Thirdly, convincing the Ummah. A few weeks ago, myself and others spoke at Hizb ut-Tahrir's conference attended by 120,000 people in the Bung Karno Stadium in Jakarta, Indonesia. This conference was organized as part of an effort to build a groundswell of support and understanding for the Islamic Khilafah system. There I discussed with another speaker, Sharif Zaid, Hizb ut-Tahrir's spokesman in Egypt. He said that when they traveled around Egypt in recent months holding seminars outlining the Islamic Khilafah's economic, social and political solutions, people were surprised, impressed and supportive because they are Muslims. Many Muslims said these ideas were new to them, though this is a Muslim country. So we, the Islamic activists, need to work hard within the Ummah to show how the Sharia solutions revealed by Allah address their everyday needs. So they don't just love Islam emotionally, but demand the implementation of the Islamic Khilafah system instead of looking to secular solutions which are bound to fail over time, just as Western societies are today experiencing economic and social meltdown and the loss of confidence in democracy and capitalist economic solutions. These latest events in Egypt must be a wake-up call and a reminder for us all to join hands and work even harder to convince people of the duty and viability of applying the Islamic solutions by re-establishing the Islamic Khilafah state. May Allah aid us in this work. May Allah protect our Ummah in Egypt.